I'm going to use Minitab Express to find the sum of squared error, or SSE, using the observed number of teeth and the predicted number of teeth. So I'm going to need the regression equation, and I have found that in a previous example. So just taking a peek, going to my navigator pane, the regression equation. Where'd it go? I lost it. It should be in my output here somewhere. Oh, there it is. I apologize. It is 30.6176 minus 0.7972 tattoos times tattoos. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and create a third column of those squared differences between the observed and the predicted. And then I'm going to go ahead and have Minitab sum them up. Now, in your output for the regression equation or the regression model, it does give it right here. It's 23.985. Now, in your homework, some of the problems, they will give you the data set and the regression equation, but the regression equation will have the slope and the intercept term rounded. So rather than use the raw data set and running the model and looking at the output, to get your answer to be correct, you're going to have to use their rounded version and create a third column and sum it up. All right, so to do that, I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to my data menu and going over to formula because I want to create an expression that will put in the observed y value minus the predicted value, that difference squared in each of these cells. So my expression is a little complicated. I'm going to put an outer set of parentheses because that's going to end up being squared. It's going to be my observed values, which are the number of teeth, minus the predicted values or the predicted number of teeth using the regression equation. So I want to subtract and then open up another set of parentheses, and that's where I'm going to put the regression equation. So the regression equation was 30.6176 minus 0.7972 times the number of teeth. Oops, that's a mistake right there. And that's going to cause problems for me. Okay, so 7972. And I still have that other set of parentheses. And then I want to multiply that value, and I need to use this asterisk times the number of tattoos. Okay, so here, right here in this smaller set of parentheses, I have my regression equation. So it's the y values, the observed y values, minus the predicted y values using the regression equation. And then I need to square that difference. So outside of the larger set of parentheses, I'm going to use this caret key, which means to raise, and I want to raise that to the second power, and then click on OK. And then you'll see Minitab has created a third column, and that third column is going to be each cell will be the difference between the observed value minus the predicted value squared. So I need to sum up this third column. Very easy to do. Go back to your home screen, I'm sorry, go back to your statistics tab, click on describe. We want descriptive statistics, and we want it for that new column that was created. And clicking on the statistics tab, all I am interested in is the sum. And then you'll see that the sum here is exactly what was given in the original output when I ran the linear regression model. Again, if I had rounded the slope and the intercept term, I could have put that in for my expression instead. So watch out for that in the homework.